Hello guys, it's me, Murdercore. I'm here with Misery. Hello man, how are you?
I'm doing good, thank you.
How do you enjoy the tournament so far?
I like the tournament a lot actually. I like Pogo West a lot. It's my first time here and like the weather has been really good.
Yeah.
So it's actually, it's a really good tournament I think.
Did you have the time to check out the city?
Not so much. We had some walks around the city and stuff like that, and we have a view over the city actually from our hotel.
Yeah, are you staying in Intercontinental?
Yeah.
Yeah, you should have a good view. I hope that you're on the upper.
We're far up.
Yeah. So you should have a good view of the city. It's actually quite nice around there because you can. I assume that you can see the old city from there, Parliament and stuff like this. So yeah, you did well in this tournament. This interview is taken just after the final game was played on the tournament, and okay, I won't spoil, but the finals, I mean. You got third place, are you happy with it?
Yeah, we're okay with it. We're pretty satisfied, I think.
Is this something you expected, or you expected to perform better, perform less successful?
We would always go in for the top three, for sure.
Yeah, of course.
But we didn't. I don't think anyone thought about expectations too much. We go into the tournament each every game to win, and then we just see how it goes from there.
Do you have anything that made you special? How to say it? Was there something good or something bad that you felt here? In particular, like this was bad, this was good.
In the event, or
yeah, in the event.
Well, I think it is a bit like a dream hack, you know. There's a lot of noise and a lot of people and a lot of fans, and it's really, really hot inside. So, and then it's hot outside too, so that doesn't help. So I think that's probably the worst part about it. The good part is I think all the fans here are amazing. The crowd was cool and the stage was nice. Pretty much everything else I feel was really good here. So
you can say that you enjoy it and you will leave positive about
the
event.
For sure, for sure.
Okay, I want to ask some questions that will bring you in your childhood, I think. What was the first time, what was the first game you played ever? Like a video game, computer game, whatever. What was the first game you remember playing?
That's probably Hercules on PlayStation.
On PlayStation? Oh, yeah. I remember this game.
The
PlayStation 1?
Yeah,
I remember this game. It was some jump and run, something like this.
Yeah.
It was nice game. Actually, I used to play this game too.
That's good.
I don't know if you had this in Sweden, but the coin machines that you insert coin and you play with sticks and buttons.
I know what you mean.
Have you played on these?
I never really played that much.
Never
this type of game, no.
Okay, what was the first game that got hooked you up and you said I'm gonna be the best on this game?
I didn't really. It was like I played Dota a lot. I liked playing Dota. I didn't really think like that. I guess to some extent I thought.
I mean, what was the game that...
It was Dota for sure.
Yeah.
Dota caught me. Every other game, I lost interest in a month or something.
For how many years are you playing Dota?
Soon 10 years, I think.
10 years? Yeah. God.
Maybe 8 years, but yeah.
Yeah. It's up there. Still, it feels a lot of time you invested in this.
For sure.
You played as a stand-in for a few teams in the next 6-7 months or something like this. I'm not really sure, but you finally found your place in Cloud9. Are you happy with the team?
I'm very happy with the team. Everyone is really happy with each other. I feel it's really good atmosphere in the team. Yeah, I think it's very good. I'm really happy with the team.
Are you getting along pretty well?
Yeah, everyone's getting along.
So there is no pressure, there is no bad emotions in the team. You just play and relax and discuss everything that has to be done together.
I think on LAN especially, like in real life, it's a lot better than online. Online we can get annoyed at each other sometimes, but on LAN everything is much easier. So yeah, it's really good.
You have been in quite a few teams, to say. I remember you. That was the time when I started to be interested in Dota at all, because I haven't played Dota 1 like at all. I was introduced to Dota more seriously in Dota 2, and by that time you were playing in Mousesport. That was the time before TI3.
Yeah.
After that, as I said, you played in quite a few teams. Yeah. Is Cloud9 the place you feel the most at home, if I can say this?
Yeah, probably Cloud9. In Dota 2, I'd say, like right now, Cloud9, the way the team is and everything, it's probably the best team I've played with. Yeah, in a very long time, at least.
So. You are for sure in Cloud9 right now. You're a group of very skilled people, people that know what to do, know what their goals are, and know what to do when in game. Do you feel like you have a good chance at TI5, because this is obviously the next big tournament that everyone is looking to?
Yeah, I feel like we definitely have a shot. First we're going to go to the Summit in California, and then we're going to go to a Chinese tournament, and then maybe ESL if we qualify. So I hope that we can learn a lot from these three tournaments, maybe win one of them, so we have some experience in winning before going to TI.
What are your expectations for the Summit, by the way? Because it's a tournament that the concept of it is not to be a very serious tournament. It's a tournament where you should get along with every other player, relax, play some other games, drink some beer or whatever, and have fun. But no. Still, the prize pool is so big that you have to play seriously.
I think it's still very serious.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone is going there just to party or something like that. Everyone's going to try to win. But I don't know about the expectation. It's going to be a really hard tournament. All the Chinese teams, three Chinese teams are going.
Yeah, VG, IG, and
LGD, I think also.
Yeah, I think so.
Secret and us, and I don't know exactly who's going, but we need to work on some things when we get back, and then we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. I wish you good luck in this tournament, and of course in every other tournament you're attending. What do you think actually about the redemption vote that was held for the Summit 3? Do you like the idea?
I'm not really sure what I think about it. Maybe it would be better just to have one more qualifier slot in Europe. But then again, the IG won, so you can't really do that. It's probably a good idea. It's not bad.
It was like a lot of popularity to this tournament, because every team was trying their best to make the people vote for them, and everyone was hyping the tournament. So in this way, I think that it's good for the tournament. But do you think this is good for the teams? Do you think that this all the promises and all the effort that was put into this redemption vote can be put in another direction that will help the team grow any other way?
Yeah, maybe. I think there was definitely some of the teams that were trying really hard to get people's attention. And I think it should be maybe not based on some AMA from Havost or I don't even remember. I didn't really follow, but like they could probably do something, maybe. Like I don't actually know. I don't really mind this so much. I didn't follow it so much, but I think
it's okay.
It doesn't. Yeah, it's okay. It doesn't have so big impact on anything really.
Yeah.
I think every team wants to go to the Summit. If they miss the qualifier, of course they want to try to get to the Summit. So it's natural.
Yeah, I can understand the teams, of course. So I hope that actually hope is not the word, but I'm thinking that you follow the scene very, very, very closely.
Mm.
So what are your expectations for the? For the meta shift with the new patch that is anticipated in this very moment, what do you think will change in the patch? What do you think has to change? Because it's all speculations right now, but still,
I'm not sure. I think sniper, troll, some of those heroes that are being picked a lot, they're gonna get some slight nerfs, and maybe some of the heroes that are not picked, they're gonna get some buffs as usual. And then I think, yeah, maybe some changes to. I think Radiant is a bit too strong compared to Dire. And some things with the rubber band effect that has been talked about a lot. Maybe that will be changed a bit. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. And if 1 week.
If there were three things that you can change in Dota right now with the patch, what they would be? Just three things come in your mind in the first place.
I don't know. I think you would have to nerf Sniper's Shrapnel or his range, attack range. Probably Shrapnel nerf is good. And then I think they should somehow change something with Dire, because I really feel like Radiant is a lot stronger than Dire.
What in particular seems so strong about Radiant just against Dire?
The Radiant jungle is a lot better. It's a lot better for supports. They can pull better.
It's more efficient.
More experience, more efficient. I think the rune advantage, level one, level one runes are a lot easier to get from Radiant, I feel.
Yeah.
And I personally think the Radiant offlane is also better. So it's just, everything seems better on Radiant, from my point of view, in terms of early game and laning phase. And then, yeah, I mean, Roshan, you don't have Roshan advantage anymore on Dire, so...
Okay.
It's that from Dire they kind of lost by moving Roshan, so I think they need to change something with Dire, maybe the jungle or something. I'm not
sure. Yeah.
Well, I am looking at your games. I'm following you for quite a while now, and I think that right now the synergy that you have with your team is rather good. What do you think will be the factor that will? That will be the tiny bit that you need to overcome the competition in the next tournament. What do you think has to change in your play as a team?
Yeah, I don't think I think we just need to change and work on our communication in the game. And if we do that, I think if we had better communication in these games, I think we would have won against IG for sure. And then VG, we also had really poor communication in one of the games. So I think that's the first step to becoming better.
So, right now you feel that the communication is the only thing that can be improved in your play as a team, of course.
Well, there's many things we can improve on slightly, but the communication is the biggest flaw that we have right now, I think.
Yeah. Let's talk about this tournament so far. Do you feel that there were any unexpected turns of the events?
Oh, I think Secret dropping out that early was a surprise to everyone. And then Malaysia team beat Secret and Malaysia got really hyped, and then they end up losing and dropping out right away.
Yeah.
I mean, it was kind of weird, and that we ended up meeting Tinker again. So that part of the whole who drops out early was kind of surprising, I think. Apart from that, I feel the Chinese teams you would kind of expect to go for. So.
Did you expect VG to win?
Yeah, I mean, I expected VG and IG to do as good as they are doing. So.
To be honest, I was not rooting for them, but I even made a small bet for VG. So I think that it was kind of expected. But yeah, you did well in this tournament, and I really hope that you are going to perform even better in the future tournaments. To make happy all your fans, of course, yourselves, and your beautiful manager. Thanks to him, by the way. He's the guy that made this interview possible. Any last words?
Yeah, well, shout out to all my sponsors and Cloud9 and all that stuff. That's it.
That's it. Yeah. Okay, thank you for the interview. Good luck in the future.
Thank you.
And see ya.